Hey guys. Happy 2020. This year is our year, right? It's our year, baby. So guys, I know I missed all of you though. I miss you guys too. Like, I miss my fucking kitchen, you know. But I've been away all this while and there was little or nothing I could do. How was your holidays though? Mine was fantastic. Mine was fun-filled. Mine was experimental. Mine was adventurous. I really enjoyed every bit of it. So 2020, like I said, is our year. It's our year of joy, our year of happiness, our year of fulfillment, our year of gratitude, our year of thanksgiving, our year of harvest. If you sowed anything 2019, this is your year to harvest it. If you did not sow any seed 2019, it's never too late for you to be whatever you want to be. It's never too late for you to do what you want to do. It's never too late for you to sow the seed that you wish to sow. So, in the course of the holidays, right, we had so many meats. We had so many chicken, we had so many turkey, we had so many of that. And now that we're back, I got thinking, what am I gonna cook anyway? So I thought to make stew. I'm filming by myself, right? This is the first time I'm filming by myself. Yeah! This is 2020, man. We're fucking shit up. And we ain't waiting for nobody, right? We are not looking for no validation, right? We're just gonna do what we wanna do, right? Oh yeah, I know you feel me. I know you feel me. So, I wanna make a very local stew. Because I'm tired of the meat and the chicken and all of that, I'm gonna be cooking fish stew. I'm using ice fish, which is popularly known as titus. Port Harcourt call it cumbia. I don't know. Yeah, I'm a Port Harcourt girl, in case you didn't know, but that's a story for another day. And then I'm using this very, very handy fish called banla, right? And then I'm using my cow skin. Because it's local stew, we're gonna go local. And I'm gonna be adding a dash of red oil into this stew. Oopsie. Like, I can't wait. So, my fresh tomato and my fresh pepper is all here. And if I'm making stew, I do not forget to have my garlic and my ginger present. And then I love to blend my tomatoes with, you know, two or three balls of onions. It gives it this extra. You know, when it comes to cooking, right, most women don't know, but when it comes to cooking, it's the little things that matter, just as in life, right? Because in life, it's the little things that matter. And the same thing applies to the kitchen. It's the little things that matter, because we can have the same recipe, but your sauce won't taste like mine. Why? Because I pay attention to the little details. Or you don't. But now I'm here, so you can watch and you can learn. You're welcome. So, first things first, to get started, I have to fry my fish. If you want your local fish stew to taste really great, you want your fish fried. And to fry my fish, I have to, you know, season it first. Some women tend to steam their fish before they get to fry it. But I don't understand the logic behind that. I mean, frying is a method of cooking. So why steam and then fry when you could just fry? I know, right? So to get my fish frying, I have to marinate it with my seasoning cubes, right? So I have my seasoning and then I have my salt. And then I have my black pepper. I have my pepper in the raw fish. Yes, in the raw fish, baby. Then you tend to, you know, mix them together. So you mix the fish. You keep mixing your fish. It's 2020, bitches. Okay. Now my mixing is complete. I throw my fish into the freezer bag If you don't have a freezer bag in your kitchen, that's fine. You could just get a clean nylon bag and get your fishes inside. Then you zip it. This is how you cook for your man, ladies. Stop going to the fast food to buy him food. These guys, they stress a lot. They suffer to get this money that we enjoy to spend. The least you can do is feed his stomach, baby. If you don't know how to cook, learn. Be loyal and learn. So that's the second batch in my freezer bag. You zip it. And then I'm gonna go put this in the fridge to just allow it to marinate for like say 5 minutes so that the spices could get into the fish before I get to fry it. Yo, lady, this is 2020. Buckle up. Buckle up. Stop sleeping. Take care of your man's stomach. And if you don't know how to, learn how to take care of your man, okay? Stop going to people's DMs to fight. My husband is following you. Can you help me and block him? For real, bitch? I'm not blocking your husband. He's following me because he likes what he's seeing, okay? You don't want him to follow me no more. Spice your sex and your kitchen and your married life up. Okay? Someone actually had the nerve to slide into my DM to send me that message. Her husband is following me. I should block him. If he's following me religiously, like you said, that's because he's seeing something here that he wants. So why not be a smart woman and get to give your husband what he wants, right? That's what smart women do. If you want your husband to sit his ass down and follow just you on Instagram, then by all means, do what all Instagrammers do, that is following. So basically, this is me just removing the bones from the fish. I didn't do that when I got to wash it. Okay, so having prepared my fish, damn, this fish is delicious. Why can I have to blend my tomatoes? Let me quickly wash up my hands. So with my tomatoes, I add my ginger and my garlic cloves. Then I add 3 bowls of onion because I love my stew rich. So I blend 3 bowls of onion with my tomato and my garlic and my ginger. This is the pot I'll be using to make the stew. So because I need the oil that I use in frying the fish to fry my tomatoes, the oil you fried your fish in actually makes your stew taste better, right? So because I'll be using this pot for my stew, I'm gonna use this pot for my frying of fish too. Right? Guys, this is how it's done. It's called cooking. It's called cooking. My fish is out from the freezer, and at this time, the spices have really, really gotten into it. This is where I put some of the blended tomatoes. Because it was too much for the blender, I still have some inside there, so I have to, you know. So, the frying of the fish. Extra flavor to your fish or whatever it is you're frying. I don't want to fry this in 2 batches, so they're all gonna be there. That's how fish fries. Yeah. Yeah. I know you didn't know, but that's how fish gets fried, right? Uh-huh. I know you didn't know that. It's not your fault. Your mama never taught you. But big sister is here to teach you everything you need to know. So fish is frying, girl. Same oil in the same pot, you add your onions and start frying your stew. And I think I want a little bit of palm oil in this stew to enhance the local taste. Just a little, a dash of red oil. Is that enough? I was supposed to add this before the onion, but I didn't remember. And there's no big deal anyway. Nothing's spoiled because I wasn't gonna use the red oil. The granite oil is hot enough to get everything going. So now, goes in. This red oil that I added is a game changer because it's going to bring out that local flavor that I want, coupled with the fish too. So the fish is really, the spices got into it. And I add them. You add your seasoning cubes. Mm-hmm. With your tomato on the fire, you go in with your seasoning cubes. Season. It's called seasoning. Then you add a little bit of salt. That is how you cook for your man. Stop taking him to restaurants. Add my fresh pepper. So now I'm adding tin tomato, right? I love to add all of this at once so that they get to business. Some people like to add this like later, but I don't get the logic behind that. But this one also has to cook. So the earlier it started cooking with the rest of the fresh stuff in there, the better for everybody, my taste bud included. So I'm supposed to use spoon to get all of this up. Up your tin tomato with your fresh tomato. This way, all of them get to cook at the same time. I know, you're welcome. I know you didn't know all of this. You're welcome. Another thing I like to do is to add my cow skin. Yes, I'm frying the tomatoes, but remember that this cow skin has no fucking taste, right? So if you put it at this point, frying it with the tomato, you get to give it that taste. That makes sense, huh? You're welcome. So I put this, I stir it. I'm still frying my tomatoes, but I didn't get to steam this thing, so they're not gonna have any taste, right? Like if I was steaming meat or fish or something, I would have added it there, but since I need to give it a taste, I have to dunk it while the tomato is still frying. So having put all of that inside, you cover and let it fry. Okay, my tomatoes are frying responsibly. Remember to stir at intervals. Keep frying until the whole water in the tomato is done. It's dry. Like, I wish you guys can perceive the aroma I'm perceiving. Fuck! It's that type of. I get to cook and I get to dance.
Sumbala ja, give me sumbala ja, give me sumbala ja, give me sumbala ja. Aruti ene tseile. Omali cha chocolate. Gela di tatu yu body. If you give me a go collect, cause I carry your matter for my head. Oh, my little chocolate, then I battle your.
So we're gonna wait for the tomatoes to dry. My tomato is dry, so I'm gonna show you how. You see how it is? The oil is separated from the. You can see the oil on top. That's how you can tell that your tomato is really dry. And then we stir it too. It starts to stick to your spoon. You can tell it's dry too. Did you know that? Did you know that? Were you aware of that? I don't think so. But you're welcome nonetheless.
You're welcome.
My tomato is dry. So now you're gonna want to add your fish. Your fried fish and stir together. I'm gonna add a little bit of salt. Then you add a little bit of water. Just a little water. Oh my. It's called cooking, ladies. It's called cooking. That's what you should do for your man. Not taking him to the restaurant for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That's not fair on the man. Nothing beats a home-cooked meal, right? It's called cooking your food. So, we're gonna let this simmer, and then that's it. You can enjoy this with volume, white rice, potato, plantain, because it's a local stew, local palm oil fish stew, so it goes with basically anything that goes with stew. If you give me, I go collect, cause I carry your matter for my head, though. Chocolate.
chocolate.
We have been enjoying this week's white rice. Yeah. White rice. Excuse me. White rice. Yeah. White rice. I see what it looks like, right? This is local native palm oil fish stew. Oh my god. Oh my goodness, this is the real food, man. This is what you need. Thank you for watching. You know the drill by now. See you next time.